Let's take this case study related to final accounts. Here we are expected to pass adjustment entry. Let's go item by item. Item number one, salaries outstanding rupees 20,000. Salaries and expense, okay, expense should be debited. Outstanding means it had become a liability, it is not yet paid. So outstanding salary should be created because liabilities will be created, right? So entry is like this. Since date is not given, I'll just mention the item number one. Salary debited being an expense, 20,000. Outstanding salary created, basically it is a liability being salary outstanding. Okay, second item is prepaid insurance. Prepaid expense becomes an asset, so it will be debited, and it is reduced from the expense, so expense should be created. Okay, so look at here, prepaid insurance, insurance is the expense here. Prepaid insurance account debit and credit goes to insurance account, that is the expense being insurance paid or prepaid, being insurance prepaid. The third item is interest accrued on investment. How much? 1,000. Interest accrued, income accrued will become an asset, so asset should be debited, and here this interest is basically an income, so that should be created. So look at this entry. Item number three, interest accrued on investment account debit 1,000, it's an asset, so it is debited, and credit goes to interest account, being an income it is created. Okay, or we can even say interest income account, to interest income account being interest accrued on investment. Okay, then item number four, commission received in advance. Commission received in advance becomes your liability, so that should be created. Since it was already credited in income, you have to remove it. For that reason you have to debit. So commission income account have to be debited, commission received in advance account have to be created. So look at here, commission account debit, it means it's basically you are debiting the commission income account, okay, and credit goes to commission received in advance account being commission received in advance. Okay, item number five, to provide 10% interest on capital of rupees 5 lakh. So what is the capital? 5 lakh. 5 lakh into 10%, 50,000. Interest on capital is considered as expense of the firm, okay, so it should be debited, and credit should go to capital account. Okay, so here interest on capital account debit, it is basically 5 lakh multiplied by 10%, that is 50,000, right? So interest on capital account is debited by 50,000, and credit goes to which account? Credit goes to capital account. 50,000 will say being interest on capital provided. Item 6 is closing stock. We know closing stock is an asset, it will be debited. And where we are parking this closing stock? Credit of trading account. So trading account will be created. Item number 6. Item 6. Closing stock account is debited by 4 lakhs and credit goes to trading account 4 lakhs. We'll say being closing stock recorded.